Chairman Chaffetz and Nunez to come on the program. They declined. I spoke to Congressman Hoyer a short time ago. Congressman, some of your Republican colleagues in the House think that Michael Flynn's resignation resolves this matter. Representative Chaffetz saying, quote, the situation is taking care of itself. You disagree, right?
Absolutely. There's no way that his resignation takes care of this event. And very frankly, Mr. Chaffetz nor Mr. Nunes, who chairs the Intelligence Committee, would have thought that had this been Mrs. Clinton in the same position. I'm absolutely positive of that. It is not enough to say, okay, the National Security Advisor has resigned. We have here a pattern, not just a single incident of failing to disclose to his superiors that, in fact, at least that's our supposition, that's what they say, that it wasn't disclosed, that he had talked about an ongoing matter of sanctioning behavior that was adverse to the United States of America. And in effect, one could draw the conclusion, because the Russians did not respond to those sanctions, that they had been assured that they would be alleviated in the future. Now, I don't know that. I'm just speculating that that's the fact. But it is a very critically important question. And it's a critically important question is not only what the National Security Advisor did, but what is the relationship between President-elect Trump himself and Russia and Putin.
The White House today said repeatedly, Sean Spicer today said repeatedly in the press briefing, that it was clear to everyone at the White House that there was no legal issue with what Flynn did, that his resignation came down simply to a matter of trust. I don't understand, if there was no legal issue, if Flynn had done nothing allegedly illegal, why Flynn would lie about it repeatedly to so many people in the White House, including the vice president. Is it clear to you that no law was broken?
No, it's not clear to me. It's not clear to me that this was the only conversation. It clearly is the conversation in focus now, but it is, I think, clearly deserves investigation, because, frankly, they knew about this 3 weeks before it became public. It was only when it became public that the National Security Advisor's position was at risk. And Kellyanne Conway, just hours before the resignation, which Spicer now says was asked of Flynn, and Flynn, of course, says he decided to resign. We don't know which is the truth here, but I think there is great doubt as to whether something illegal was perpetrated or something was done that is contrary to the interests of the United States and the security of the United States, and shows a compromised position vis-a-vis one of our principal adversaries in the world, Russia.
Would any investigation be able to, whether it's in the House or the Senate or independent, would it be able to hear the phone intercepts between Michael Flynn and the Russian ambassador?
I would certainly hope so, even if that had to be in camera or in secret. Plus the fact, I think the transcript of the conversation ought to be made available, certainly to the members of the Congress who represent the American people, and with consideration that security was not breached, that transcript would be available to the American people so they could make their own judgment.
And finally, the White House says categorically the president did not know in advance that Flynn was going to have this conversation or at least was going to talk about sanctions. Do you have 100% confidence in that?
I do not.
You think it's possible the president knew?
Very frankly, President Trump has, as a candidate, and frankly going forward, has said things which are not corroborated by facts. Kellyanne Conway may like alternative facts, but Senator Moynihan said we're all entitled to our opinion, but the facts are the facts, and I'm not confident of that. I don't think the American people are confident of that. And if they are the facts, then I would think the president would want to make sure that we set the record straight by having a full and fair investigation.
Congressman Hoyer, appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you, Anderson.
Well, let's bring in the panel. Daily Beast senior columnist Matt Lewis, Democratic strategist Paul Begala, Ryan Lizzo, Washington correspondent of The New Yorker, also Trump's